frenzy. Simone de Beauvoir, The Ethics of Ambiguity, page 57. The nihilist attitude manifests a certain truth. In this attitude, one experiences the ambiguity of the human condition. But the mistake is that it defines men not as the positive existence of a lack, but as a lack at the heart of existence, whereas the truth is that existence is not a lack as such. And if freedom is experienced in this case, in the form of rejection, it is not genuinely fulfilled. The nihilist is right in thinking that the world possesses no justification, and that he himself is nothing. But he forgets that it is up to him to justify the world and to make himself exist validly. Instead of integrating death into life, he sees it in the only truth of the life which appears to him as a disguised death. However, there is life. And the nihilist knows that he is alive. That's where his failure lies. He rejects existence without managing to eliminate it. He denies any meaning to his transcendence, and yet he transcends himself. A man who delights in freedom can find an ally in the nihilist because they contest the serious world together. but he also sees in him an enemy, insofar as the nihilist is a systematic rejection of the world and man. And if this rejection ends up in a positive desire for destruction, it then establishes a tyranny which freedom must stand up against.